Respected teachers on the dais and learner audience. I am Dr. Mohammed Nijamuddin, registered Dhaka Medical College Hospital, Dhaka, going to present my presentation. This is coronary artery aneurysm. Actually, it was a presentation of Dr. Minhas. Due to some familial problem, he cannot present the presentation. So that is why I am here. Coronary artery aneurysm, basically I will present here in three segments. First I will present the pathophysiology of the coronary artery aneurysm. Then I will present a case scenario, and finally the management of the coronary artery aneurysm. There are some facts and myths of coronary artery aneurysm. The myths are very rare, less chance of occurrence, and surgical correction is the only preferred treatment. The facts is coronary artery aneurysm, when the coronary artery dilates 1.5 to 2 times of adjacent coronary artery, it is called coronary artery aneurysm. Its incidence is less than 5%, and giant coronary artery aneurysm incidence is less than 2%. The basic treatment of the coronary artery aneurysm, as it is heterogeneous origin, so pharmacological treatment, interventional, and surgical therapy to the specific cause where required. The etiology. Atherosclerosis is more than 50% causes of the coronary artery aneurysm. Besides this, Takayasu's disease, Kawasaki's disease, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, Marfan, polyarteritis nodosa, fibromuscular dysplasia are the other causes. Besides, there are secondary causes of the coronary artery aneurysm. This is percutaneous intervention, angioplasty, atherectomy, and stenting. Pathogenesis. Disruption of the intima and media is the basic histology, and this is inflammatory. Besides this, inherent defect in the artery vessel predisposes to the aneurysm. In case of the atherosclerosis, media is weakened. That is why coronary artery aneurysm occurs. In PCI, where a stent is implanted, delayed re-endothelialization and hypersensitivity reaction, residual non-healing dissection, and high pressure balloon inflation are the causes. Now, come to the case review. Case number one, I will present only one case, breakdown, patient demographics. Age 47, male, presented with unstable angina with old MI anterior. Status post PCI to LAD 1.5 years back. Hemodynamics, pulse 90 beat per minute, blood pressure 120/70, and lungs is clear. Patient have comorbidities, diabetes mellitus, and he is on oral hypoglycemic agents, non-hypertensive and non-smoker. This is the CAG underwent March 2019. It shows patient have got stenosis in the left main and LCX. Stenting was done in LCX and LAD. A follow-up. Patient found to be clopidogrel resistant, so discarded, and ticagrelor and aspirin was started. But the patient complained chest pain after 1 month with shortness of breath. All baseline investigations were normal, and LV ejection fraction 42%. So decided to go repeat CAG. Patient underwent CAG. This is the video shows the patient have got the coronary artery aneurysm. What may be the next cause, and what to the next? We advise the patient for urgent surgery, but next day patient develop STMI and septal. Management strategies. Management strategies basically risk of thrombosis and risk of the rupture and chest pain management. Here, indication for the surgical repair. Surgical repair, when coronary artery aneurysm involving the left main, multivessel involving the coronary artery, joint coronary artery aneurysm, management at a glance. Surgical correction is the preferred treatment. Aneurysmal ligation and distal bypassing grafting, isolated coronary artery bypass grafting, aneurysmal plication, and saphenous vein patch. Antiplatelet and anticoagulant both decrease the risk of thrombus and embolization. Covered stent, but it causes restenosis. Discharge antiplatelet and anticoagulation. Usually we used clopidogrel and aspirin, but the patient was clopidogrel resistant, so we used the ticagrelor. Conclusion. The best treatment of the coronary artery aneurysm after drug-eluting stent is controversial. While evidence is lacking, measures to decrease the inflammation and minimize coronary artery injury at the stent implantation site is crucial. The risk of thrombosis for the chest pain due to ACS and the risk of rupture is main concern in mind to decide for the next strategy. Thank you all.
Thank you for a nice presentation. But how did you manage that case?
Basically, I mentioned that we have sent the patient for surgery.
Surgery, okay.
Yes, sir.
What do you think, what is the cause in your case? Number one. And number two, why you suspect there is clopidogrel resistance is there?
The cause of these cases is due to stent implantation, or it may be due to high balloon pressure.
He told this case of infective cause is the number one cause in Bangladesh. Number one, number two, dissection is rare cause. The most common cause is infection, but after infection control, aneurysm not to reduce size, so send the patient for bypass surgery. But in the case, no stent cannot cover stent, not possible in the case. Also big size of fistula. So infection control is the main prime role in these cases to save the life of the patients. But patient must be sent to the bypass surgery. He did nice.
Post-stenting aneurysm was most common with Cypher stent. But drug-eluting, among the all the drug-eluting stents, so Cypher was stopped manufacturing, no more. But now this sirolimus eluting, many stents are there. We can learn after 4 or 5 years what happens to them.
Now, Anish je question koreche je ei patient er etiology na overall it common etiology tumi question korecho.
Ei particular patient e why this happen?
Tar fever chilo, infection je motion already bolche, infection. Kintu drug allergy jeno drug eluting stent e amar kotokula patient এক মাস পরে হাই ফিভার নিয়ে হঠাৎ করে সাডেন ডেভেলপমেন্ট অফ হাই ফিভার এমআই নিয়ে ভর্তি হয়েছে চেক এনজিওগ্রাম করে দেখি ডিস্টাল এন্ডে মোর দ্যান 5 মিলিমিটার অ্যানোরিজম বা ব্লাড কালচার অল নেগেটিভ তাহলে সেকেন্ড ইটিওলজি ফার্স্ট ইটিওলজি ইনফেকশন সেকেন্ড ইনফেকশন মানে ব্যাকটেরিয়াল ইনফেকশন সেকেন্ড ইটিওলজি হচ্ছে অ্যালার্জি টু ড্রাগ লুটিং স্টেন সিস্টেমিক ম্যানিফেস্টেশন অফ দ্য অ্যালার্জিক রিয়াকশন থার্ড হচ্ছে যে হাই বেলুন ইমপ্রেশন হাই প্রেশারে স্টেন ইমপ্লান্টেশন আদার ইটিওলজি হ্যাঁ তা তো স্বাভাবিক একটু পুরাতন বেলুন দিয়ে যদি ব্যারোট্রমা করো তো মোর চান্স টু ডেভেলপ পোস্ট ডাইলেটেশন অথবা পি ডাইলেটেশন যেটাই করো আমার মনে হয় এটা চান্স ইনফেকশন এবং অ্যাজ ওয়েল অ্যাজ ব্যারোট্রমা বেশি হবে স্মুথ ইউনিফর্ম মোমেন্টামে ফুলবে না অতএব এটা ইঞ্জুরি অফ দ্য ওয়াল ইনসাল্ট বেশি হবে
ডিসেকশন ইজ দ্য ইম্পর্টেন্ট কজ aneurysm. But most important in Bangladesh is the infection because we found lots of cases, usually in government hospital. In my government hospital, because you use the reuse and the staff is not so much trained up, so there is chance of aneurysm is government hospital more, number one. Number two is the, we found some of the tuberculosis, pericardial infection, yes. And some is the tuberculosis infection also common in, I saw in
Sir,
the
post-PCI, in case
the TB in Bangladesh. So we should meticulously control the infection in the our cath labs.
Sir.
Lots of technicians, trainees, doctor, trainees, cath lab staffs moving around the cath labs. So we should be control the infection in the catalepsy.
Sir, if this is infective cause, will it be following the regime of infective endocarditis, and how long will we be continuing the antibiotics in that case?
লিটারেচারে বলছে যে পোস্ট কর্নিয়াল আর্টারিতে যখন এই এন্ডো আর্টারাইটিস হয় পোস্ট স্ট্যান্টিং ওয়ার্ল্ড ওয়াইড এটা ফ্যাটালিটি রেট খুব হাই এবং ইনফেকশন এটা অ্যান্টিবায়োটিক কনজারভেটিভ ট্রিটমেন্টে ভালো হয় না এবং এটা ট্রিটমেন্ট সবখানে বলছে আলটিমেটলি ইউ হ্যাভ টু গো ফর সার্জারি মানে আমি কোথাও দেখি না কারণ আমরা দুই তিনটা কেস পেলাম অন্যখানে করেছে তারপরে আসছে জ্বর পরে আমরা দেখে বের করলাম যে আসলে এটা ইনফেক্টিভ অ্যান্ডোআর্থ্রাইটিস আফটার স্ট্যান্টিং
অ্যাজ অ্যান ইন্টারভেনশনিস্ট আই ক্যান সে অ্যাকচুয়ালি সামটাইমস উই হ্যাভ নাথিং টু ডু অ্যানিরিজম পোস্ট পিসিআই অ্যানিরিজম লাইক এ থিং লাইক দিস উই ক্যান উই রিগার্ডিং ইনফেকশন উই শুড টেক কেয়ার অফ দি পেশেন্ট নাম্বার ওয়ান নাম্বার টু What should we do? Proximal dissection or distal dissection. This is if edge dissection. So after stenting, you must be careful to look at your stent edge, whether there is dissection or not. In this case, you stop at the LAD ostium. LAD ostium. Actually, in this case, I already faced three cases like this. In case of LAD ostium, LAD ostial lesion, we sometimes compromise whether I shall go to left main or not. In that case, sometimes there is disease in the LAD ostium. I just put a stent in that disease segment. There is a fracture of the plaque, and there is dissection and high pressure system in the left main, and there is a chance of aneurysm. What about the cause if there is medial tearing or there is weakening of the arterial wall, if there is long time pressure, it will ultimately, what about the cause? It may be infection, it may be hypersensitivity to drug, or it may be dissection due to balloon or stent. What about the cause? It may cause the aneurysm.
Thank you. Next.